Alright fellows, hello and welcome back, Kojiro from Gaming in Japan here, and in this video guys, I will be talking about Sougetsu in Samurai Showdown 7 or Samurai Showdown 2019, and I'm going to say this right off the bat, I think this character is super boring in this game. I'm saying this from the position of someone who have played Sougetsu in every single Samurai Showdown game since Samurai Showdown 4, when he debuted pretty much in the series. And in the end of the video, I'm going to show you a little bit of a footage from Samurai Showdown 6. So just you can see some of his basic tools there compared to what he can do in this game. So, I'm not going to explain every single one of his normals and stuff, because at this point in the game, I think a lot of people are familiar with how the basics of the game works. He has a far-reaching normals with his hard slash. He can sometimes cross with the hard slash, as you can see here, but he cannot do that with the jumping kick. And it's really hard to cross someone up with the normal in this game with this character, but that's the least of his concerns. So this is his far-reaching hard slash. This is his emblematic normal, which he had since the first game. He has a far-reaching like hard slashes, which is his like staple normals with his long range. But the thing that I dislike the most about this character is his special moves and the bare bones version of his special moves that he has in this game. So this is his dashing kick. He can use that to knock down the opponent and to set up the zoning game with the bubbles. The bubbles are awful in this game, in my personal opinion, compared to Samurai Showdown 5 or 6. But more on that later. So after a throw, he can do a crouching medium into a mid shoryuken. From a back throw, he can do just the standing hard slash. From a forward throw, he can do a dash hard slash or crouching hard slash. And his combos are basically close mid or far mid into the shoryu, a gazer, or far crouching mid into the shoryu. Like, this is his basic combos. He cannot do a shoryu from forward and kick. His kicks are okay. They're not like what Ukyo can do. And yeah, you can use the bubbles as a setup trap and do normals to push the opponent into the bubbles. But the bubbles themselves in this game don't have a great hitbox, and their duration is the shortest duration from any Samurai Showdown game, other Samurai Showdown game that I can think of. So as you can see, this is a very short duration for the bubbles, guys. I mean, the opponent can just wait them out, and if he gets hit for some reason, the bubbles themselves don't do that much damage, and they don't have that much of a greater like hit stun after they hit the opponent. So yes, you can do the follow-ups like this. You can burst, make the opponent hit the bubble, and then do a super in order to just do a lot of damage to the opponent. But you have to be a little bit more stricter in this game, because like I said, the bubbles themselves have a awful hitbox and have very awful duration time when they're on the screen before you have to reset them. Yes, you can move them around, you can use them in some cases. If you see the opponent jumping while you're doing the motion, you can use them as an anti-air, but they are not like a super hard tool for the opponent to deal with, in my opinion. I still haven't played any matches with Sougetsu in this game. Don't know if I'll play the character at all. Okay, so here is his teleport. He can do three versions of the teleport. He can do a back teleport in front of the opponent or to the back of the opponent, and you can use that obviously to just space out and position yourself in a better position relatively to the bubbles on the screen. But like I said, the bubbles themselves don't have a lot of duration on the screen, so I don't really see how you'll be able to use that as a zoning tool too much. And by the way, this is another super frustrating thing. Let me just show you one more time. So when you actually have the bubble on the screen and you hit the opponent with the super, unlike the normals, you don't add additional damage from the bubble during the super. Like, just look here. Okay, the bubble just stays there and the opponent doesn't get hit from it. It doesn't add any damage. I don't understand why this is the case. I mean, yes, generally speaking, like, the character does a lot of damage. I mean, in terms of his damage to his hard slasher and, or to his combos with the middle slash into a Shoryu, like, I don't think he does low damage at all, but just his tools, guys, his tools are awful in this game. And like I said, this is my opinion relative to what he can do in other games. His dash speed is also, like, not something to write home about. I mean, he was way faster, his dash was way faster in Samurai Shodown 5 special, for example. And yeah, I think there are characters in the game that can space way better and with way more variety. Galford, for example, with his puppy and his, like, what was it, like a plasma projector, whatever it was. Like, I cannot stand Galford, but he has way more interesting tools than the Sogetsu in this game. By the way, when he gets disarmed, this is something that I don't have any problems with. He doesn't have any special moves, and this is how it should be. He has all his special moves connected to his sword. But yeah, this is something that I don't really mind, that he's helpless without his sword. But overall, guys, I don't understand why he doesn't have the forward like special move with the dash slash into couple of hits into a like a mini gazer. This is his super desperation move, or super special as I like to call it. Yeah, it looks cool, it's awesome, but you cannot connect it after you put a bubble on the screen into a burst into the super special like this. I don't understand why this is the case. I mean, I don't get it. Maybe you can do that in certain situations, but it doesn't seem like generally very straightforward applicable. And this is just one more thing in the list of things that I dislike about this character. This is only, of course, day one stuff from me. There might be some other tools and applications of some stuff that I haven't discovered, or I just don't know. But overall, I think this character is really boring in this game. And just to show you a tool comparison for Sogetsu in Samurai Shodown, now I'm going to show you how this character looks in Samurai Shodown 6 Tenkaichi, which is a game from 2006. It was on arcade and PS2. I also have it on PS4 because I love the series. And let's just do a very basic comparing of his tools in the older version of the game. Now pay attention in Samurai Shodown 6 how long the bubbles stay on the screen. He can also burst the bubbles here. He cannot control them. This is a new thing for him in this game. But he can do a bubble in the air with the kick version of the button, with the down forward and kick. And just, did you see how long the bubbles stay on the screen compared to Samurai Shodown 7? Okay. He can also has this special move, this with the down, back and slash. And yeah, he can do that to sort of like a combo in a different way compared to just a Shoryuken. Yeah, he can do a combos like this. And he also has fake versions of both his teleport and his gazer Shoryu type of special move, okay? This is his teleport and this is his fake gazer Shoryuken. Did you see that? So I don't really understand what is the downside of having some tools like this in order to just mix up the opponent better and just keep them guessing. And this is a reversal that he has in this game, okay? He has a reversal to normals in which he can use them to just appear behind the opponent. It doesn't lead to any direct damage, but yeah, he can just teleport like that from a hit situation, and this is a tool that is brand new for Samurai Shodown 6, by the way. He didn't have that in 5 special, for example. And he's overall a more interesting character. Oh yeah, he can also do a down hard slash in the air and do a cross-ups with it, and he can also jump from the wall, and unlike Samurai Shodown 7, he can actually do a low jump from the wall. You have to just press down, and you can do combos like these. You can jump off the wall, do a mid into a Shoryu, or a mid into a down back light attack for the little slash gazer. I forgot the name of the special move, but yeah, he has a lot more tools in this almost 15 years old game compared to Samurai Shodown 7, and this is just disappointing for me. This is only my honest personal opinion about this character. I don't mean to discourage you to play him in the new game or anything like that, but it's just disappointing for me as someone who was hyped at the first moment that I discovered that this character will be in the new Samurai Shodown game. As you can probably remember, initially he was leaked in Japan in some arcade demo or something like that, and then it became clear that he will be a part of the new season pass. By the way, the new season pass in the UK European region, season pass 2, is still not released as of the moment that I'm making this video. I bought Sogetsu separately. I didn't bought Mina because I don't really care about Mina. I'm probably not going to buy Iroha if there is no season pass. And my just basic random prediction here is that the last character from the season pass 2 will be Yokai Kusare Gedo from Samurai Shodown 5. That character is insanely interesting and original. But as far as Sogetsu goes, I really do not imagine someone who have played the character in any previous game that he'll be super excited to play him here in Samurai Shodown 7, considering the tools that he has and the properties that these two have in this game. I might be wrong, of course. If you disagree with me, that's totally okay. Please let me know what you think down in the comment section below. Let's have a discussion on this. But if you have played this character in any previous games and you actually like him in Samurai Shodown 7, please just let me know what you think and what are your reasons, because I just don't see it, guys. I'm sorry, I don't see how anyone... I know that I'm repeating this probably for a fifth time already, but I don't understand how anyone who liked this character in the previous titles will like him here, considering the tools that he has in this game. Let me know what you think. I would love to hear from you. Thanks for watching this video. I will have the basic combos in the comment section below in the first comment. And thanks for watching, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye! あげましょう。終わりです。消去完了。